Daily Devotion with Pastor Balla for February 12, 2023 from Ephesians chapter 4. Hanging onto the gifts from God. Previously, we heard about Paul talking about the gifts we receive through holy baptism. Through holy baptism, we receive the gift of faith and the Holy Spirit. Paul then explains a little bit more about this from Ephesians chapter 4, verse 8. Therefore, it says, when he ascended on high, he led a host of captives, and he gave gifts to men. This quote is from the Psalms. It's a beautiful passage that depicts Jesus freeing us from the bondage of the devil. It also notes Jesus' ascension into heaven. And when Jesus was ascending into heaven, he told his disciples, stay in Jerusalem until the Holy Spirit, another gift we receive through holy baptism, comes upon you. So let's continue with Ephesians chapter 4, verse 9. In saying he ascended, what does it mean but that he had also descended into the lower regions, the earth? He who descended is the one who also ascended far above all the heavens that he might fill all things. So Paul is teaching us that, yes, God descended first. He took on human flesh and blood, was born of Mary, born in Bethlehem, and eventually crucified on the cross and raised from the dead and ascends to heaven to be at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. This, of course, was done to defeat sin, death, and the devil so that humanity may be connected to Christ for eternity. This is the message. But then how does the message get out? Verse 11. And he gave the apostles, the prophets, the evangelists, the shepherds, and teachers to equip the saints for the work of ministry, building up the body of Christ. Paul here is teaching that God gave us apostles, prophets, evangelists, shepherds, teachers to proclaim God's word to us and to administer holy baptism, the Lord's Supper, which are means to equip Christians for the work that they need to do for, like we just heard yesterday, being patient and gentle with humility. All of this is done for the building up of the one body of Christ. Now, as we serve one another in love and humbleness and gentleness, which Paul mentioned, we are also encouraging one another to go and do likewise. Besides, the Holy Spirit is leading us down this same path, and we need these encouragements, not only from the Holy Spirit, but also from other brothers and sisters in Christ, because as human beings, we were created to be in community. You see, it's not just me and Jesus, and it's not just me and the Holy Spirit, but God places us and calls us into a community of believers for the purpose of encouraging one another in the Christian faith. Verse 13, until we all attain to the unity of the faith and the knowledge of the Son of God, to mature manhood, to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ, so that we may no longer be children tossed to and fro by the waves and carried about by every wind of doctrine, by human cunning, by craftiness in deceitful schemes. Again, Paul reminds us why we need to be present in the church, so that we may receive this encouragement, because we live in a world that is sinful. And we live in a world that tosses many things at us, that trying to encourage our sinful nature to rebel against God. Paul even names it this way, human cunning by craftiness and deceitful schemes. Yes, we live in a world that is constantly trying to pull us away from Christ. So what do we need to do? Continue to gather where God's word and sacraments are leading us back to Christ through the Holy Spirit. And that takes place in the community of believers. Again, sometimes people ask, do I really need holy baptism? Again, the answer is yes. God commanded it. And God says you need it People also ask, do I really need to go to church? Again, the answer is yes. God commanded it, and you really need it. So we continue to gather around God's holy word and sacraments. We continue to encourage one another in the Christian faith because we really need it, or else we will fall away. God's peace and many blessings be with you, and thank you for listening. And please take an opportunity to share this message with others. If you have enjoyed these daily devotions, please consider making a donation to Peace Lutheran Church, 24024 West Main Street, Plainfield, Illinois, 60544. Thank you again for listening.